This is setup of the Wyze vacuum. You have the charging dock, the charge cable and large power brick, and you've got the unit itself, and then one side brush. So first we're gonna flip it over and attach the side brush. So just line up your square peg there. You'll hear it click into place, and there you go. And we can flip it back over. And then based on our starter guide, we kind of did step two, which is click the brush. We're going to get the charging station in place. For me, it's going to be a little tricky because my placement of my robot vacuum is under my entertainment center. So let me get this situated and then I'll bring you in to show you what I did. For me, based on the cable length that I see there, I probably won't use one of the interesting features of this charging dock, which is the bottom actually opens up. That's where you plug it in, but you can also wind the cable in here to kind of help with cable management. Now, based on the length of this and the power supply that I'll be plugging into being there and the unit sitting over here, I don't think I'm gonna actually use this, but because it's gonna live under the entertainment center, I wanted to make sure that I showed you this is an actual interesting concept because cable management is difficult.
Here you can see, again, cable management is horrible down here, except for this guy, which it did end up wrapping the cord underneath, so that was a benefit. So here you can see it's on, you see the lights on, and then we move on to the next step.
According to the pamphlet, the next thing we do, now that we have power in the docking station, is we press the power button for 3 seconds to tell it to go charge. So let's try that now. All right, so it was a little longer than 3 seconds, but you can see it's pulsing now.
Turning on.
It just talked. It said turning on. I don't know if you heard that. So it's still sitting there blinking. My assumption is it probably wants to connect to the app. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna skip ahead and I'm going to jump into the app right here and we're going to select add a new device and we're gonna come down, we're gonna find the vacuum. So what it wants me to do here is press and hold both the buttons until it says Wi-Fi connection. So since it's not doing anything and going to the charging dock, we'll give this a shot.
Wi-Fi connection has been reset. Awaiting network connection.
All right, so it says Wi-Fi connection has been reset and it's flashing, so we're gonna hit next. It wants to know my network password, so we're just gonna throw this in really quick. All right, and then from here, I need to connect to the Wi-Fi network that this has created. So we're just gonna come down, I'm gonna search for my Wi-Fi networks, and we're gonna look for the one that says WVCR because I have a Wyze base station also hanging around and sending out its own Wi-Fi connection. So we're connecting the phone. And if you have something on your phone that will not connect to a Wi-Fi network that does not have internet connectivity, you wanna make sure that you kinda tell your phone it's okay, just disconnect to it. So once you're connected to this network, you say, choose, which I did. So I select this one and now it's connecting. So that's still flashing. This is still flashing. Could take up to a minute. So we'll see what this does. Then hopefully after it connects here, it will actually go to its base station. Because I was surprised that it didn't automatically go. I have it right in front of the base station, which is just under there. Yeah, look at that. Connected it. So what we're gonna do, I'm just gonna give it a name. I'm just gonna call it Wyze Vac and finish. Option to share this device if you want to. We're gonna say maybe later. And next we're going to complete setup. So this one wants you to now plug in the charging station after you've attached it to the app. So the pamphlet that comes with the vacuum and the directions from the app, slightly different. We're gonna say next. This one wants me to actually physically move that to connect. We're gonna hit next and there's a firmware update that it needs to do. So what we're gonna do first is I'm going to take this and push it under there and then do the firmware update because apparently that's what it wants me to do.
All right, so I didn't quite catch that on camera. When I pushed it back there to charge, notice when I finally made contact, these will blink orange and it says starting to charge. So know if you have this in a place that's a little difficult to get to, wiggle it around until you actually get those connection points in the back and you hear starting to charge.
Now you can see my vacuum sticking out right there. We are going to update the firmware. And again, this can take some time, so I won't subject you to sitting through the firmware upgrade. We'll do a time marker of 252 and see how long it takes. Firmware took a total of 2 minutes, and the robot vac said turning on, so I'm assuming the reboot cycle, and then informed me that the update was successful. Talking robot. All right, here you go. This is what it looks like when you're done. Now, obviously, I haven't sent this out to do what it needs to do yet. This is just what it looks like for the initial setup.